Hi, this is Anne with Graphic Design How To, and today I'm going to go over what it's like to be a full-time graphic designer at a company versus freelance versus full-time content creation. All right, let's get started. Graphic design has evolved so much in the last 20 years, and I think it's because of the advent of the internet. So there are so many more opportunities available to us as graphic designers, but there's also so much more competition. I feel like 20 years ago, most of us who went into graphic design just wanted to get a full-time job, and that was kind of the thing that everybody did. There were some freelancers, of course, but now I feel like if you have a full-time job, you're probably also doing some freelance on the side. So many people have moved into full-time freelance. I know a lot of my friends have, and a lot of them are doing content creation on the side. Probably a smaller percentage of them have moved into content creation full-time because it takes so long to get that started and really rolling to kind of create a full-time income. Personally, I went from full-time graphic designer to full-time freelancer and then finally full-time content creator. But most of the time, I was doing two or three of those things at the same time. So while I had a full-time job, I was freelancing on nights and weekends. And then while I was freelancing, I was also making, you know, designs for Etsy and doing content creation videos for YouTube like this. I only switched to full-time freelance when I had enough clients to support that decision. And then I finally switched to content creation when I had enough stuff up and running to support me in that case. First, I'll talk about freelancing because I think the way the world is going now is that people start freelancing in college to get experience. So it's sort of their first foray into the design world. This can be friends and family asking you to help them with design projects, doing jobs on sites like Upwork or Freelancer, taking on overflow graphic design work from agencies, or just doing work for companies that maybe don't have a graphic designer on staff. You might be designing logos, brochures, flyers, doing branding, web design, social media graphics. There really is no end to it. Here are some of the awesome things about freelancing. Flexibility. You decide which projects you want to do. You set your own schedule and you work from wherever you want. Although some companies are going to want you to come into the office. It's great for portfolio building. Freelancing exposes you to a wide range of projects, allowing you to build a pretty versatile portfolio that can help you get even more clients. Higher income. You usually get paid more, but of course, this is really up to you. You are the one who sets your hourly wage. Since you don't get benefits or a stable income like you would with a full-time job, you need to set your rate accordingly, and that means higher. And then as you refine your skills, establish your brand, and basically get better, you can set higher rates that reflect your expertise. And here are some not so awesome things about freelancing. If you don't have experience, you can feel like you have no idea what you're doing or if you're doing it the right way. This is how I felt when I first got out of college. So I decided to get a full-time job working for a company first so that they could train me. Even though I had a degree in graphic design, I was worried about unhappy clients because I really didn't know what I was doing since college is pretty much an overview. They try to teach you so many things. And usually what you're doing after college is pretty specialized. Inconsistent income. One of the main challenges of freelancing is the unpredictability of the income. It really can be feast or famine. So you really have to be careful about your financial planning and your discipline during lean times. When I was freelancing full time, there would be weeks and weeks with no work. So I would really just pour myself into finding new clients, build up my side projects, and learn new skills. It was stressful because I didn't know if the work would ever come back. Thankfully, it always did. And on the flip side of this, sometimes I would have too much work, and sometimes everything would come due on the same day. That made for some almost all-nighters sometimes, trying to get everything done for all my clients. No benefits. Freelancers generally don't get 401k, health insurance, vacation, sick time, life and disability insurance, maternity and paternity leave, tuition reimbursement, things like that. If you want those things, you'll have to find them and buy them yourself. Self-management. Freelancers are not just designers, they're business owners. So that means you have to do everything. So manage administrative tasks, marketing, finding clients, figuring out taxes and accounting. there is a lot that goes into it, and it can be so time consuming. Obviously, most of us don't consider that stuff to be fun or creative. So you probably are thinking, well, why not just hire someone to do that stuff for you? But usually there is no money in the budget for that, especially when you're starting out. Isolation as a freelancer. Working independently can lead to feelings of isolation. When I lived alone, I definitely felt like I was losing all my social skills. It's fine now that I'm married because my husband's always around to talk to. But before that, yeah, it was not good. All right, let's switch over to full-time graphic designers. As a full-time graphic designer at a company, you'll probably have a set schedule like working 9 to 5. You might have a desk in a cubicle and you'll have a boss like an art director, creative director, who gives you projects and gives you deadlines for when to get them done. And here are the good things about being a company full-time graphic designer. Stable income. Full-time graphic designers usually have a steady salary with benefits. So this is going to give you financial security that you might not have if you're a freelancer. So you might get a 401k, health insurance, vacation and sick time, and all those things I mentioned earlier, even like tuition reimbursement. Freelancers generally don't get any of that. Professional growth. Working in-house or as part of a team allows designers to learn from their colleagues. So they'll receive feedback and they'll grow their skills within a structured environment. And this right here is why I wanted a regular full-time job first before trying anything else. And actually at the time, I didn't have any desire to work freelance or try content creation or anything. The full-time job at a company was my goal. I just wanted to work at a company forever. But then after a couple years, I just kind of got tired of it. So that brings us to the not so great things about working full-time at a company. Limited creativity. In some cases, designers might find themselves working on repetitive or restrictive projects due to company guidelines or client demands. And this can really stifle creative expression. Full-time designers might have less say in the projects they work on, and this can lead to a potential loss of creative control compared to, you know, freelancing. When I worked at a company, I would do any project that came across my desk if I had the ability. And if I didn't, I would need to go to my creative director and say, hey, you know, I've never done this before. It might take me a really long time. We might want to hire a freelancer for this or somebody who really knows their way around. Bureaucracy. Corporate environments can sometimes involve a lot of red tape, bureaucratic processes, layers of approval, and this really slows down project timelines, and the changes can be never ending. All right, so let's switch over to graphic design content creation. This can mean a ton of different things, so it really depends on how you define it. For me, I just see it as putting your art out there in some way and hoping people will buy it or consume it. Some of the things I do as a content creator are YouTube videos. I sell designs on Shutterstock and a lot of other stock agencies. I sell on Etsy and design bundles. I make and sell courses about graphic design. I sell t-shirts and notebooks and lots of different products on sites like Teespring. And I'm also affiliate for a lot of different sites. I don't work for a boss or anything, so I have to really have a lot of self-discipline on how much I work. And I also don't have somewhere I go every day. I just stay at home and work from home. But I never get vacation days. I have to do something for my job every single day. So here are a few of the great things about content creation. Creative expression. Content creators have the freedom to make the art they want, as long as it resonates with their target audience or whoever happens to be consuming or buying it. Direct audience interaction. Through platforms like social media, content creators can directly engage with their audience, which is really awesome because you can find out what they want, what they're looking for, and how to help them. Monetization opportunities. Content creators can generate income through sponsorships, advertisements, selling items, merchandise, and a lot of different ways. And it's generally passive income, but you have to realize that if you stop doing it, that probably your passive income will dwindle over time. No boss. You don't have a boss, so you don't ever have to make changes to your artwork. That said, you do have to have a lot of discipline and attention to detail to make sure all your products are perfect. here are a few things that are not so great about content creation. Barrier to entry. It's hard to get started. My first month, I made 10 designs and I put them on Shutterstock. And those 10 designs were hours and hours worth of work. And for that first month, I made $1.81 total. Inconsistent income. Similar to freelancers, content creators might experience a lot of fluctuation in income, especially when starting out or during algorithm changes on the platforms. Constant content demand. Even though it seems like there are no deadlines, there actually are deadlines. For example, I've heard that this platform, YouTube, likes at least one video a week, so I need to make at least one per week. Maintaining a consistent flow of engaging content can be pretty demanding, so you have to be really careful about burnout. Market saturation. The digital landscape is pretty saturated, so it makes it challenging for new creators to stand out and gain a substantial following. So those are the three types of positions that we as graphic designers can hold. And I have to say that content creation is by far my favorite because of the amount of freedom and also not having a boss. So in the comments section, if you've had two or more, can you please tell me which you like the best and why? And I will see you next week with another graphic design video. All right, thank you.